Now, an update on Michael Jordan's wrist. It is still swollen. He has a knot on the top of the wrist. I asked him about his 3-for-18 shooting, and he had a sense of humor about it. He said now he knows how Darryl Walker feels every night.
Cartwright, Patrick Ewing, battling for position. John Starks hits the three.
Defensive player in the league guarding the basketball and perhaps the second or third best coming over to trap you from behind. It can put a little bit of fear in your heart. John Starks heard the footsteps.
Switched by Oakley. Here's Pippen with the snap. Rejected by Ewing. Jordan had him knocked away. Mason behind the back and Ewing finished it off. The Bulls looking for their first field goal. 3 minutes have gone by. Jordan gave it outside and the second portion of the regular season and through the playoffs.
The floor where he can be a scorer or a passer. This time he gets real good lift. It gives him a little bit better look.
The sprained ankle is of great significance. They need Grant hanging back in the track. Starks. John Starks with a three-pointer and a two. Starks gambled on the overplay. Jordan knocks it down. That's a three-pointer.
It jumps out to 17 feet when Starks goes to the gamble. Well, let me see if I really do have my stroke this afternoon. And you know what? Looks like he does.
Starks brushed off on the pick, allowing 13-21 points. But really did not hurt the ball. The time forced out of position by Grant, able to keep it alive. Jordan. Yes. Coming off the 10 of 12 in game three. Jordan. Well, that wasn't a good shot, but he feels it. This afternoon, Jordan. He's the high man with 12 points. Starks. And the game is tied. And quite did not connect. Here's Starks for three.
Right now in New York, I think they're happy with the fact that you did not.
Starks and Michael Jordan, who are not the best of friends,
said, I don't really know what he was saying. And then when Ahmad spoke,
clock at 7. Here's Ewing. So 27-26. Jordan for three. Yes. First three-point attempt. With a three-pointer, John Starks with the answer. It's a shooting duel between Jordan and Starks.
Strong on the wings to try and make shots in the end.
And here is Armstrong. A terrific opening quarter here in Chicago. Michael Jordan, 6-for-12 for 17. John Starks has hit three from downtown. The Bulls and both Starks and Jordan have bounced back here in game four. Substitutions for the Bulls. Brent Tucker, John Paxson, Scott Williams come on for the first time.
Play defense against John Starks to give Michael Jordan a break defensively.
Jordan squeezing his way. Mason posting up on Williams. Ewing. 40 remaining first half. Good work by Smith off the double team to find Mason. As a 4-on-2. Starks at the 2-point range. Michael Jordan making his way back. Michael has 17 points. Mason has a 3-on-2. Kicked out to Pippen. Look at
it. Well, Rivers realizes that there are numbers against him, so he tries to take the foul out in front there before Chicago has.
Here comes Starks. And Michael Jordan will shoot it. Well, there were 5 technical fouls called back in game 3. His neck, although Hannah Storm checked with the Knicks bench, and apparently Doc, at least he says he's all right, and he is moving back onto the court.
Yes, and on Saturday, we mentioned the fact that New York was running into screens. Not
Michael Jordan going to the baseline. Yes. And he's brought the Knicks within 5.
New York has done a very good job of maintaining their cool. Michael Jordan launches another 3. Michael Jordan, realizing how much time is left on the game clock, figures they can get a 2-for-1, so why not try for the 3-pointer?
Bulls looking to hold for a final possession. They lead by 7. All right, Jordan accelerates, took the shot from Oakley, although he felt it should have been an offensive foul on Jordan. I don't know, Charles might wait 4 hours next time he's at the Michael Jordan restaurant.
Michael figured everybody knew he was just going to run it down to the last 3 or 4 seconds before trying to catch New York sweeping, perhaps while they were trying to adjust their defense for what was coming up. If you're Coach Phil Jackson right now.
During the course of our broadcast of the series, Charles Oakley and Michael Jordan with game number 5 Wednesday night at Madison Square Garden in New York. We'll bring it to you 9 o'clock. Pippen inbounds, gets it to Jordan, who turns and fires. And Jack Neese blowing the whistle. He called a foul. Foul on Greg Anthony.
And who pops out, it leaves a smaller Greg Anthony to guard Michael Jordan, who just immediately goes up in his face, knows he's going to get a good look. Then the contact on the arm by Greg Anthony. Jordan realizes what's going on. He blows up. The contact on the arm. Jordan will now go to the free throw line for two.
And remaining, Jordan.
His jumper's going down today. He's not getting it ready.
Michael Jordan with 27 points.
Well, Michael Jordan gets more attention paid to him than any other player in the league. When you have one, two, and three guys coming after you at times, it can wear you down. And
now Jordan with the ball. Yes, top right. And Grant up front. Jordan looking free.
You mentioned earlier that Jordan seems to feel it in the first half. Well, he starts out the same way in the second half. He knows that he has the stroke.
Shot clock is down to five. Here's Jordan. Here starts. That's 2-point range.
And not let New York get back into the game. Lob over the top for the score. He threw the lob to Jordan down low.
Jordan got the step. Over the years, we have seen Michael Jordan have a number of magical performances. We are moving in that direction.
Spearheaded by Chicago's defense. The crowd has an ultimately right idea in mind, but Swartz tried to do it all by himself. They've been rotating back in time, got position.
Three fouls on Starks. Jordan for three.
They need Starks in the game. Then after foot faking and getting some space, Jordan gets a clean look and again hits a three.
Well, we mentioned earlier that Michael Jordan may be on his way to one of those magical days here at Chicago Stadium. He's hit 5 of 5 from the field. The third quarter, 11 of his 38 have come in the third. The most points ever scored against the Knicks in playoff composition. Sam Jones of the Boston Celtics, March of 67. The Bulls hoping to tie the series at 2. Jordan played well by Starks. Jordan for 3. Make it 41 for Jordan. Michael Jordan in the third quarter, 6 for 6. 14 points, 14 of his 41. 41 of the Chicago 80 points. Here's Jordan, and he'll go to the line.
One of the keys for Chicago is to get to 100 points. If they get there first, they feel they'll win. If Michael keeps hitting threes, they'll get there quickly.
Talking about a player who was on the second all-defensive team and who plays Jordan very well. Hand checks him, makes it difficult. But Michael has been unstoppable here today.
Yeah, there must be a reason why Jordan has led the league for 7 straight seasons in scoring. So he has an ability to do remarkable things with the basketball.
The Bulls 82 and the Knicks 72. Starts slapping for the ball, facing the head fake from Jordan.
Good position to have a shot at winning this basketball game.
And a three for John Starks. Michael Jordan with 45 points through 3 quarters. 18 of the 45 coming here in the third. An upside and a downside when one player is scoring that many points. Jordan again. A three-pointer for Michael Jordan. He's 5 of 6 from downtown. Jordan.
So the first time he sticks it standing still, the next time after one quick dribble, he gets enough room to still elevate and get a shot.
1.5 gone by in the fourth quarter. Jordan trying to post up at 7. the most points in a playoff game against the Knicks. Sam Williams. And a foul call.
You try and rush it to get the shot.
10. 54 points for Jordan.